So I get a lot of people saying that to actually invest buying SMA connectors, coax and everything else, that it makes something quite expensive to build when, you know, you're not really into it as a hobby and you just possibly want to build something just to improve your Wi-Fi on a few different occasions, not all the time. And what I've got here is a really, really cheap Wi-Fi dongle here that I got off eBay, and this, believe it or not, cost me £1.25 free shipping from China, and apparently it's got a Rail-Link chipset inside, and I'll just post in the description what chipset that is, because I can't remember off the top of my head. So I'm actually going to build a portable little Wi-Fi antenna adapter that's quite powerful and also small. So we're going to use this, like I said, cheapest chips. And there's a design out there on the internet where you can build a Biquad antenna using a sardine can as the reflector. Now, doing this, the sardine can isn't quite one wavelength square, which would be the optimum for the actual reflector. And it's just under, but to be quite honest with you, it still produces a powerful little antenna. But just bear in mind that it's not one full wavelength square. So you want a tin of sardines, obviously, and throw them away, eat them, do whatever you want with them, clean it out. And also you're going to need some wire. Now this is 20 gauged wire, and you can also get some scrap wire out of some solid copper household wiring if you don't want to go out and buy a reel of this, because it is quite pricey. And yeah, we're going to make a portable biquad antenna that you can take with you. Really good if you're staying in a hotel and the hotel Wi-Fi is downstairs. If you're quite close to it with an antenna like this, you can sometimes sit in your room and browse the internet while everybody else is downstairs in the communal area. So little things like that. It's nice to have one of these, and when it's nice and small, you can carry it around with you and take it out and use it when you feel the need. So this comes with a attached antenna. It's got no kind of SMA connector there, so you can't unscrew it. But what I'm actually going to do, there'll be a half wave pole dipole antenna in here, be a quarter wave and a quarter wave, and we're actually going to cannibalize that and use that as our mounting point on our biquad for the ground plane onto the base of the can here. And then we can use the driven element part of the coax that will be coming out of this to actually solder onto our bow tie element. So what we've got to do is crack this off without actually breaking it too much, and reveal that dipole underneath. So that lid just popped off the top there, and it has revealed it is a dipole antenna. So what I've got to do is cut the rest of this away with some side cutters, because we want to keep this intact. So we've removed all the plastic and we're just left with this small dipole antenna. Now what I'm going to do is actually desolder this sleeve off here. But I do think I'm going to actually use this sleeve, but I just want it a lot shorter so I can solder on to the back of the sardine can. So I've drilled a small hole through the sardine can, just the right diameter to fit this brass tube through. So what we're actually going to do is cut this brass tube down and solder that to the actual can for the reflector, and have this sticking up at that 15 millimeters we need for our biquad, because the biquad wants to be 15 millimeters away from this back reflector here at the base. And I'm going to cut it a couple of millimeters longer than 15 millimeters, because what I actually want is a small lip here so I can add some solder and we get a nice tight fit to the base of this can. So I'm probably going to measure off 18 millimeters and cut it down to there. Now, because I want this to actually fit flush up to this back of the sardine can, I need to get rid of this hinge system here that was originally on there. So what I'm going to do is just pop it open, and I'm hoping that it'll just pull out there. Otherwise, I'll get the Dremel and cut it away. So I've cracked the dongle open to remove that peg, and there's quite a lot of space in this cavity here. So what I'm actually going to do is drill a hole through there so I can attach this cheap tripod that I got from the pound shop, and I'm not bothered about unscrewing it. What I'm going to do is actually epoxy this in place into the base of the dongle there, and this flat side here I can actually epoxy that to the sardine can, which is going to be our antenna, and I'll have a nice strong structure there for the tripod. Then we can stand it up, and yeah, it should work out quite well. And there we go, that's worked out rather well. I'm quite pleased with that. So I'm now going to actually solder that brass tube in place, and I've got it to the right length. I'm holding it in there with some masking tape on the underside. And the secret of this is to prepare both surfaces and tin both surfaces beforehand. So, and flow some solder in there now, we should get a nice joint. So the tube is actually soldered in place, exactly 15 millimeters away from this back reflector. So what we're going to do now is actually build the biquad element itself. So I'm now making the biquad element for this antenna, and I'm not going to go into too much detail in this video of how you make one of these, but I'll put a couple of links in the description to my other videos where I've gone into depth of how you can make a biquad antenna, and they are really, really easy. So if you check those videos out and then come back to this build, you'll know exactly how to make one of these. It is probably my favorite antenna, really simple to make, and it gives a lot of gain, so really well worth making. So as you can see, the epoxy's set now, and it's done a pretty good job. It's in there quite tight. The actual tripod itself has been epoxied onto the back of the actual sardine tin, and the dongle is also epoxied in place, as well as this being screwed into the dongle itself, so it's not going anywhere. So what I've actually done here, I've got the outer braid of this coax, stripped it back, and I've packed it down inside this tube, along with this part of the biquad element here. So those two ends actually go into that tube and make contact with that outer braid. And then the inner part of the coax, I've just stripped it back. I've left a little bit of insulation here, so it's not making contact with that tube. And I've wrapped it around here, ready to actually solder on. So what I'm going to do now is actually solder here and solder there, and then this antenna, or the element I should say, will be in place and it won't go anywhere, and we should get a nice connection. So to make a cover for this antenna, I did think about using plastic originally, and then cutting it out, sticking it in there with some epoxy, and then giving it a spray. But this is an idea that I want to try for this antenna, and I've got some felt here. It's quite thick, but I've got a piece here, and I've got some PVA glue. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to soak the felt in the PVA glue and leave it on top of this plastic, and hopefully in a couple of hours it should set, be really rigid, and should be able to cut out the shape to go over the antenna, and then we can stick it in place, and we can even spray this with some paint afterwards when we paint the rest of the antenna itself. So that's saturated the PVA glue now. What I've got here, I've got a another tin of sardines, and I'm just going to place that over the top, and then I'm going to add some weight onto that, and hopefully it'll leave a indentation of where to cut out, so it should work out quite well. So the cover come out quite well. It's not quite as stiff as I wanted, but it's okay. It's just a different idea from using plastic all the time. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to drizzle a line of epoxy all around the edge of the tin here, and then just stick that in place and give it another spray of paint to tidy it up, and I think we'll be good to go. So the paint's all dry. That turned out rather well. I'm quite pleased with this cover. It's a nice alternative than using plastic. And I think all that's left to do now is to give it a test. So first of all, I'm actually scanning for my test router using the laptop's internal card and internal antenna. And I have got it a little bit closer than what I normally do, because the signal on the laptop was down to 10 to 15%. So I moved it slightly closer than how I normally have it. But as you can see there, it's not a very good signal. It's picking up. It's just under 40%. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to stop that and then choose the antenna that we've just made using that cheap Wi-Fi dongle. See what happens. So as you can see there, well into the 90s, much better strength, and I've designed this Like I said, if you were in a hotel and you wanted to try and get some Wi-Fi in your room without paying extra, of course, and you'd stand a much better chance with one of these than your internal Wi-Fi card. So I hope you found that useful, and even with a USB extension cable, this build actually still comes in well under £5, so really worthwhile doing, and nice and small, put it in your suitcase, take it with you, and you will always stand a good chance of getting a Wi-Fi connection. So I hope you enjoyed it and found it useful. If you did, please, as always, give it a thumbs up, and hopefully you'll join me on the next one.